Your humble host here. So this is a remake of a video I made way back when. The backstory of it's null and void at this point. Either way, being a Christian myself, I have come across other followers of my faith that will completely throw anything science-related out the window. I don't believe in all the findings of science, as science itself is an ever-evolving theory for many things, but I will say that some of it, or rather a good portion of it, is conclusive. Here's a video of a fellow believer doing exactly what I just mentioned with science. Which science in particular? The study of dinosaurs. Or rather, more specifically, the pterosaur.
Hello. Hi, it's Kristen. Just wanted to talk to you tonight a little bit about, surprise, dinosaurs. I wanted to specifically talk about the aerodynamics of dinosaurs and the lies that these paleontologists have been feeding you.
Paleontologist, a scientist who studies fossils. Paleontology, the science of the forms of life existing in former geologic periods as represented by fossils. How do these scientists lie when all they do is study remnants of the past? I know that there are and can be discrepancies with some findings, but to say the entire study of fossils is a giant lie is far-fetched at best.
For your entire lives, in exchange for millions of dollars, a pat on the back by the liberally biased media, and big high five from all the feminists out there who want to kill babies and scream at their bodies, their whatever the heck they scream.
An average salary of a paleontologist falls between $25,000 to $90,000 annually. It depends on the position of the paleontologist. Assistant professor starting position is $50,000, and that depends on the university that they teach at. And then there are three other base pays here for the museum paleontologist. Bargain basement salary, which is the lowest, is $25,000 annually. Stratospheric salary, which is the highest, almost $90,000 annually. And the average salary is $35,000 to $65,000. And then there's industry based paleontologist, which studies fossils to locate oil. They get paid almost $140,000 annually. I don't know about you, but I haven't seen anything having to do with paleontology in the news lately or in recent articles. And was that an attempted pot shot? What does feminism have to do with the topic of your video? Keep to the aforementioned subject, please.
So tonight I wanted to talk to you about the pterosaur. Silent P. What else are you hiding? Just kidding.
Really? That was really painful just now. Humor's not your strong suit, is it?
And so what the pterosaur was it was a flying dinosaur. And it had big leathery wings, very wide, and it supposedly flew.
Pterosaur, meaning winged lizard, flying reptiles who were the earliest vertebrae, meaning animals who have a backbone or spinal column, known to have evolved power of flight. Their wings were formed by a membrane of skin, meaning a pliable sheet-like structure acting as a boundary lining or partition in an organism, muscle and other tissues stretching from the ankles to a dramatically lengthened fourth finger. They existed from the late Triassic period to the Cretaceous period. Also, they're not classified as a dinosaur at all. Pterosaurs share a common ancestor with them known as the archosaur, but that's it. Instead of giving a vague description, you need to at least give some detail or small description as to what a pterosaur is, which is not a flying dinosaur.
So, I wanted to first cite an experiment that was done in Minneapolis in 2002. And what this experiment was they wanted to take something that they knew would fly and they knew would glide as a control in an experiment. And what they decided to use was a kite. And so they took this kite and they took it to the top of a four-story building. It was 70 feet tall. And so they let it go off of the building And at 2 seconds, it was down to 65 feet. At 5 seconds, it was down to about 45 feet. And then at 7 seconds, it was all the way down to about 30 feet. So in the scale drawing, you can see how the kite flew on its own off the building.
Okay, just a few things. First of all, I can't find the experiment you mentioned anywhere. I spent a good half an hour or so trying to find it. I googled pterosaurs flight Minneapolis and a few other combinations. Second, you have no citations, nor sources, or even a link to a diagram showing the blueprints of the contraption that was made for the experiment. Also, going back to the description of a pterosaur, a kite doesn't make sense considering that the pterosaur had the ability of powered flight, meaning it flapped its wings to stay in flight. It didn't just glide. Flapping, moving the wing produces thrust, to push against something, this case being the air or wind. Gliding, to move in the air, especially at an easy downward angle, solely by the action of the air currents and gravity, or by momentum already acquired. And how did you come up with that scale drawing? Did you copy something down, and from where? I would really like to follow along, but can't. It helps to give sources and links so people can understand full well what you're talking about.
And what they wanted to do was test out this theory that the pterosaur was actually real and that it had leather wings.
There are many fossils that prove that they were real. Also, leather is a man-made material using tanned animal skin. A pterosaur's wings were made up of a membrane of skin, muscle, and other tissues, not man-made leather. I know that no research was put into this video whatsoever. This is just another bashing video of Christians ragging on science. Typical.
So what they did was they took a very similar substance, a very similar thing, and they put it on the kite and let it go. So they took a leather jacket out of their closet. And as you can see, they equipped the kite with the leather jacket. And they're still at that same 70 feet, but at 2 seconds, they're already down to the 45 feet. At 5 seconds, they're down to 12 feet, and at 7 seconds, they're all the way down to the ground at 0 feet. So in this scale drawing, you can see the whole difference of where that kite was at each stage of the experiment.
Okay, just from your description of the experiment, or rather both experiments, it sounds like A, you misread or misinterpreted the experiments itself, or B, you found a poor excuse of a science project done by a bunch of lazy kids. Either way, one cannot tell without resources, which you have yet to provide any. Also, had you done any research whatsoever, you would have come to the same conclusion that this entire experiment does not make any sense to begin with. Leather is heavier and not as light as a membrane, plus the pterosaur's body was made to ride the wind currents and to be able to stay on them due to them flapping their wings. Kites are only made to glide for a specified amount of time depending on how hard the wind is blowing. You can't call a kite and the body of the swing lizard the same thing. There's so much information that's missing from this experiment, as well as factors that renders this science display null and void. Surely even you could have picked up on that, or are you just letting your cockiness get in the way of actually learning something different from outside of your perspective on things?
After 7 seconds, the kite was on the floor when it was equipped with this leathery wing. Could it have happened in real life? You tell me. Go to your closet and grab a leather jacket. Open up your window and throw it out. What do you think is going to happen? Guarantee you it's not going to fly. It's not going to go gliding off into the breeze. It's going to fall like a sack of bricks.
Well, no duh, it's going to fall. Leather jackets don't fly unless you're living with Mary Poppins. There is no way that you're this ignorant, and forgive me, this stupid. You're really agitating me with you calling the membrane on a pterosaur's wings leather. You know, this is why all the other communities and other people find Christians to be arrogant and crazy. Just from your attitude in this video, you come across as a complete know-it-all, which is far from the case. What is wrong with learning something new? Just an FYI, Genesis was written in Hebrew poetry and not for factual science. It's a poetic expression of how Earth was created. I'm just putting it out there.
Now imagine that leather jacket is 40 feet across. Like the pterosaur. 40 foot wingspan. With these leather-like membranes on their wings. Tiny little tail that does not allow for leverage, and these bulging eyes, which have been shown to not be good for flight.
If you did your research at all, you would have found that there were varying species of pterosaurs ranging in different sizes, some with smaller tails and others long. Also, their eyes weren't bulging. Their eyes were located on the sides of their head, and they had to tilt their heads to see better. One more thing, with research, you would have seen that there is very little published about their sight and eyes. I looked and found that they had limited binocular vision due to the location of their eyes and not because they were bulgy.
So this dinosaur supposedly flew. And this dinosaur supposedly existed and was around, and you know, it doesn't make sense. This is the type of dinosaur that makes these atheists and these paleontologists sit there and say, oh, dinosaurs are just like birds. Oh yeah, birds, they're what dinosaurs are now. And no, it's not true.
It doesn't make sense to you because you're not even willing to try and understand the findings behind it. I'm not saying you have to agree with everything that science says, but dang, atheists with scientists don't call dinosaurs birds. There is a study of the taxonomy which branches out how each species came to be. I myself don't agree with all the findings of this particular study, but you don't see me sticking my nose in the air at it just because it didn't come out of the Bible.
They never flew. They never existed. Dinosaurs do not equal birds. You can't just say, oh, yeah, here's this piece of bone in the ground. It means that there was a dinosaur that had wings and it was made out of leather jackets and whatever else they're trying to say. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't exist. So I think with these experiments that have been proven and just common sense in general, you can say that there's no way that this dinosaur, this pterosaur, ever existed the way that paleontologists are saying that they did.
Oh my gosh, you are not one to talk about common sense here. Common sense dictates that you look at all the evidence presented and the studies, then you get to make a decision. Again, you don't have to agree with all the findings as there can be discrepancies like I stated earlier. But good grief, it seems like you're not even willing to read anything on the study of dinosaurs or this pterosaur at all. And how do you know the pterosaur didn't fly? Where is your proof that says otherwise? Again, what experiment are you referring to? The experiment sounds like a load of bull too. Can you at least look at the science of taxonomy and try to get an understanding from that? So I will say this, this attitude or way of thinking is very frustrating and leaves a negative image on those Christians that aren't afraid to question our beliefs look into the other studies that are out there. Also, are you so shaken in your faith that reading something that doesn't have alignment with the Bible will make you turn away? Honestly, it is good to question what we believe in and how things work in the world. It is how we come to understand a great deal which helps us grow. We can then pass our knowledge of what we've come to learn from God and science to others. Like I said, I am a Christian. From one Christian to another, this is not how you are to behave when dealing with beliefs or studies that you don't agree with. You need to take time to study and understand them properly to debate. Also, provide biblical evidence for your reasoning, which I will admit is tricky as there are discrepancies how old the earth really is and such. There are mentions of the behemoth in Job 40 verses 15 through 24 and the Leviathan in Job 41 verses 1 through 32. It is not known what exactly the Leviathan or the behemoth exactly is in the Bible, but they are physical descriptions of animals and not just an analogy. Again, do your research. All in all, I do come across this sort of thing a lot with people of my faith. There is a difference between just flat out choosing to be ignorant versus actually taking the time to understand how other people think, which in itself can prove difficult. But if you are at least able to understand how other people feel about things a little bit more, then I'd say you've accomplished something. This goes for everyone, as I know that there are people who don't believe in God or the Bible and will try to debate by just randomly picking up verses and stating the Bible supports said idea because of said verse without actually taking the time to study said verse in context and why it was spoken at all. I know we're not going to agree on everything, but my goodness, disagree intelligently. I know that there are other factors that can persuade our beliefs or what we're willing to study too. I want to leave you all with this verse, Ecclesiastes 3:11. He has made everything beautiful in its time. He has also set eternity in the human heart, yet no one can fathom what God has done from beginning to end. And on that note, I will end it here. I will talk to you guys later.